Well, Vladimir Putin's issued a dire warning to any country that looks to intervene in Moscow's invasion will face a lightning-fast retaliatory strike. The UK is undeterred. Foreign Minister Liz Truss calling for more military support for Ukraine.
If Putin succeeds, there will be untold further misery across Europe and terrible consequences across the globe.
It comes after the UN revealed 12 million people have been displaced since the conflict in Ukraine began. World Vision Australia's CEO Daniel Wordsworth is on the ground in Kyiv and he joins us now. Daniel, you've been travelling the region meeting many of the refugees. What does the situation look like for them right now?
Lisa, this is... I've just been on a journey through, I think, what's best and what's worst about being a human. I've been through towns where almost every inch of their space is taken up with sheltering refugees. I've been in churches that have pews pulled together with mattresses put on top. And then I sat yesterday with families from Bucha, from Irpin, and I'm just hearing, some truly heartbreaking things, but I'm also seeing Ukrainians stepping up in a really, truly remarkable way with some compassion and generosity that's sort of unprecedented, actually.
Daniel, do you have a sense of how many of these refugees are children?
Yes, I do. And I have it actually at both levels now. Before I came here, I knew the statistic. That statistic was that half of the children of Ukraine are displaced and have left their homes. But you get the sense of that when you're actually on the streets in a place like Kyiv. It's like a tide has moved through these streets and carried these children away. It's mostly all adults that you're seeing. So these kids have been displaced, they are scattered throughout this country and they are scattered into countries around Europe. I think one of the most symbolic things that I saw for kids was that in one of the schools that I was in, they took me downstairs and they showed me a room. And when I saw it, I thought it was a kindergarten. It was like a vibrant yellow color, had beautiful images on the walls, a little library, a little play area. And I said, is this your kindergarten? And they said, no, this is the bomb shelter that we have for children. And they spend so long in here and it's so traumatizing that we wanted to give them a fun place that they could be in for all that time.
Daniel, you've painted such a vivid picture. What do the Ukrainian people need most from Australia right now?
Well, the first thing they need is our attention. This is not going to be a short-term thing. You have cities that are 80% destroyed. You have 300 bridges that are gone. But more than the physical destruction, you have had people that have gone through an ocean of suffering. And this is going to take years to recover from. And they need people like us to stay with them on that journey. I can promise you that your charity World Vision, we're going to be there. We just want to, you know, carry Australians with us as well into that environment.
Well, if you would like to donate to World Vision's appeal, just head to worldvision.com.au. Daniel, thanks so much for your time. Thank you for all that you're doing and please stay safe.
Thank you all.